The Pritzker name is everywhere in Chicago. As one of America's wealthiest families, they've donated to everything from schools to parks to zoos. Their name's clearly spelled out for everyone to see on things like the Pritzker Pavilion in Millennium Park. But when it comes to the most famous Pritzker of all, our current governor, there's some confusion. Is it J period B period, or is it just JB? Well, Dom from Naperville asks, how do you properly spell the governor's name?
His name is J-A-Y, Robert Pritzker, and he was named after two uncles. And his father wanted to not favor either uncle, so he was immediately nicknamed J.B.
There's something about this too, right? He was trying to do something with this, just to be known as J.B.
He ran for Congress in 1998 and used periods in his initials. When he ran for governor this time around, they created a new logo, no periods. The periods make him less approachable.
How have publications around Chicago and around the country handled J.B. Pritzker?
The Chicago Sun-Times, the Chicago Tribune, the New York Times all follow AP style and use periods and no spaces in his name.
In the Pritzker family, he's been known as J.B. ever since he was a little kid. In his period before he was governor, he went as J period B period, both at his foundation and his venture capital firm. It's a question of politics and punctuation, and it's all very confusing. Sometimes you just gotta go right to the source.
During the campaign, I didn't use periods in the signage that we had for the campaign. And that when I got elected and they put signs up with the name of the governor, there were no periods in it. What happened to the periods became a question for people.
What is the correct way to write it then?
Well, we've told everybody, just forget the periods. It makes it harder for everybody. Nobody knows how to space it out anyway. There's no reason. Why does anybody care? So JB without the periods works just fine.
Why do journalists and language mavens obsess about things like this?
It's all in the details. If we don't get the details right, how can readers, viewers, listeners trust anything we say on the really big stuff?
So they say you never get a second chance to make a first impression, but clearly if you're the governor of Illinois, you get a second chance to make an initial impression.